Hi, I'm Joe Morgan, a flat fee financial planner from Best Financial Life, and I'm sharing some money moves that might be good for you to explore. This is not financial advice. Financial advice is specific to you and your situation, and I don't know you. If you need specific financial help, talk to your financial planner or reach out to me, either way, but please take this for what it's worth. We're just talking about general tips and hints and money moves that we might want to do. Now, let's get into today's topic. Today, we're talking about the three things you want to know about your company stock. Now, specifically, what I'm talking about is the company stock that you own that has likely been awarded to you through either options or RSUs, or maybe you've bought through ESPP or wherever. That's what we're talking about, the three things you want to know about your company stock. First thing is, with all due respect, you don't know where it's going. Okay. It could be going up, it could be going down, but we don't know where our company stock value is going. We just can't tell the future like that. And a single stock is much more volatile than a group of stocks. So if we go back to the 2008 crash, one of the worst crashes in history, the stock market was down something like 60%. That's tremendous. To have your portfolio, to have your investments drop 60% is awful. It's terrible. But markets behave that way and they come back, sometimes quickly and sometimes not so quickly, but it always comes back. A group of companies always comes back. Individual stocks do not always come back. And I'm sure if I sat down, I could come up with a list of 100 companies that I've seen in my investing career that have basically gone to zero. I mean, a lot of those back in the dot-com days, pets.com and Peapod. Peapod was a great story, right? They were delivering groceries. You order them and they deliver to your house. This was the late 90s, something we pretty much take for granted today. But that business model didn't work back then. But it was very popular for a time in terms of the investing community. And so were a lot of other companies. And so individual stocks are by definition going to be more volatile than a group of stocks. The second reason why I say you don't know where it's going is your company has a single CEO and a single board of directors. And if you haven't noticed, they're humans. And humans don't always make the best decisions at all times. And you may have a superstar CEO and a superstar board of directors, and they're probably killing it, right? I'm not saying they're not. I'm just saying that there are times when people make mistakes. And by having your money in a single company, you're susceptible, more susceptible to those mistakes than you are if you're in a group of companies. Because in a group of companies, those mistakes can be offset. Mistakes over here can be offset with good decisions or better decisions over here. So a portfolio of stocks will be less volatile for that reason. And here's the third reason why I say that you don't know where your company stock is going. And this is probably a little bit controversial, and you may be a little shocked to hear this at first, but I think when you think about it, it's going to make sense to you. Here it is. Every single company will eventually go out of business. Every company that exists. Now, why do I say that? Well, because it's the smaller companies, the growing companies that can innovate, that can move more nimbly and use the current technology and use the tune in to the new cultural changes of the customer base, and take that market share away from the older companies. And the older companies can get stuck in their ways. New companies, of course, are always trying to innovate. Now, new companies can go out of business too, of course. But there are very few companies who stay in business for a long period of time, because It's just too hard to stay on the front end of thought processes and desires and cost consciousness that it takes to be successful. So those are the three reasons why I say you don't know where your stock is going to go. Now, the second thing you need to know about your company stock is that you own too much. I can say that pretty confidently, even though I don't know your situation. And I'll tell you why. Your income comes from your employer. Your paycheck, your bonus, the future stock awards, that all comes from your employer. So it's a very undiversified source of income. And that's the way it is for all of us. We all have a job. Most of us have a single job, and we're undiversified in terms of our income. Now, your stock that is part of your wealth, you own stock that is part of your wealth. And that, of course, is tied to the same company. So now you've got investments in the company stock, and you've got income coming from the company. So now not only are you undiversified in your income, but you're tying your wealth to the exact same risk set that your income is tied to. And then on top of that, you have unvested stock. You have stock that's going to be part of your future wealth, and that is also tied to the company. So I can say fairly confidently that if you get stock awards, you probably own too much stock. And so that's the second thing that you should know about your company stock. The third thing is the government owns some of your stock. If you have any stock and you've had it for any period of time and it's gone up, then some of that growth is going to be taxed. And the government's going to take it away. The state government, the federal government, they've all got their hands in it, right? And so you're taking the downside risk of owning the stock, and part of the upside is going to the tax man. So the government actually owns some of your stock. So when you log in and look at your holdings and you see that big number, and normally they show you the unvested balance too, right? Which you don't even own yet. But they show you this big number, that's not all yours. Some of that belongs to the government, and they will get it if you're in any sort of growth position if the stock has gone up. So those are the three things that you should know about your company stock. Number one, you don't know where it's going. Number two, you own too much. And number three, the government actually owns some of the stock that you have. If you have any comments or questions, please reach out to me at joe@bestfinlife.com. Have a great day.